It's 3 o'clock, and school is out. The children can't wait to start playing. What will the boys do this afternoon? Jimmy, Steve, and Bobby are talking it over. Jimmy is a new boy at school, and he'd like Bobby and Steve to come over to his house to play. He says there are a lot of things they could do. He'd like his new friends to come. Bobby and Steve are glad to be invited. Jimmy explains where his home is and says they can walk home with him right now. Steve thinks that's a good idea. But Bobby doesn't. He's going home to tell his mother where he will play. You coming, Steve? Steve knows that's the right thing to do. They'll both go home first and see Jimmy a little later. This is one of the streets that Bobby and Steve and the other children cross each day on their way home. All the children wait at the curb for the crossing guard signal. They walk carefully between the two lines, and they don't run or push or shove. The boys are so busy talking about some of the things they might do at Jimmy's house that they're not watching where they're walking. Uh-oh. Steve has hurt himself. It's not too serious, but it could have been a lot worse. Someone wasn't careful about where he left his bicycle. Never leave bicycles or toys on sidewalks. And always look where you walk, whether you're walking on a sidewalk or crossing a street. A car stops and the driver calls to the boys. The man seems to know Bobby. He says he's Mr. Arnold, a friend of Bobby's father. Bobby thinks he knows Mr. Arnold, but he's not sure. But Bobby knows that he must not ride home with anybody unless he has permission from his father or mother. He tells Mr. Arnold, "No, thank you." Mr. Arnold knows that the boys are following a safety rule. Don't ride with anyone unless you have permission from your parents. Yes, the boys are remembering their safety rules after school. Here's another one. Look both ways before you cross. At home, Bobby asks for permission to go with Steve to Jimmy's house. Bobby's mother says yes. She knows that Bobby is old enough to take care of himself. But he must be home by 5 o'clock. Bobby understands, and he will be careful. And Steve will go too if his mother gives him permission. But his knee hurts a little. Bobby explains that Steve hurt his knee on the way home from school. Bobby's mother is glad that the boys mentioned this, because now she can help. She'll have a look at the knee. A little first aid is probably all that Steve needs. While she gets a bandage for the cut, Steve is going to call his mother to ask about going to Jimmy's. Of course, he knows his phone number and how to dial it. Calling home to ask permission or to let your mother know where you are is another way to practice safety after school. Can he go to Jimmy's? His mother says yes, but she wants him home by 5 o'clock. Steve says he will be home on time. And now let's see about that knee. It's just skinned up a bit. Bobby's mother washes Steve's cut with soap and water. It's always best to take care of a cut right away so it won't get dirty or infected. Next, she puts on a clean bandage. There, the bandage is in place, and Steve will be able to play safely. Now let's see if the boys think about safety on their way to Jimmy's house. There's something that isn't safe. It's very dangerous to ride a bicycle that way. Well, looks like the Johnsons have a new dog. He seems friendly enough. Steve wants to pet the dog. Does that seem safe? Bobby says no. The dog may be unfriendly. It's best not to be too friendly with strange animals. Now Bobby and Steve are coming to a street they've never crossed before. If they cross between the parked cars, they can't see the traffic too well. And the drivers may not see them. Never cross in the middle of a block. Steve and Bobby do the right thing. They walk to the corner. They look both ways and cross safely. Just across the street, some new apartments are being built. Wouldn't it be fun playing here? There are so many places to hide. And so many things to climb. And look, there's a fire where scrap wood is being burned. Some boys are playing near the fire. Bobby and Steve know this is dangerous. The other boys know they shouldn't be doing this. That's why they run when the workman comes. The workman tells Bobby and Steve that they can't play here either. It's not safe. Why, just a while ago, he says, the wind knocked down some of those large boards. Someone could have been hurt very easily. No, this is not a safe place to play. Anyway, Jimmy is probably waiting. They'd better hurry. Jimmy is raking in his backyard. A yard is usually a safe place to be, if we help keep it safe. Jimmy drops the rake when he sees his friends. Is this safe? Someone might trip over the rake, or even worse, step on the sharp teeth. He picks up the rake so nobody will get hurt. Jimmy's mother says he may go now and play with his friends. Where shall they go? Jimmy knows a place where they can play safely. It's a playground in a park near Jimmy's house. Steve knows what he'd like to do. Climb the monkey bars. Jimmy's trying the swings. Notice how he gets off. He doesn't jump. Before he gets off, he makes sure the swing is almost stopped. One of Steve's shoes has become untied. He'll tie it before he climbs up again. A loose shoelace can make you trip. Bobby has found some broken glass near the sandbox. He picks it up very carefully so he doesn't cut himself. He'll put it where it belongs, in the trash basket. But even in safe places, like a playground, accidents can happen. So everyone should always be careful. Time to go home. Bobby and Steve promised to be home by 5 o'clock, and they will. They'll see Jimmy in school tomorrow. At home, Bobby tells his mother what a good time he had. She's pleased that Bobby can take care of himself and can be trusted to follow the rules of safety. You can follow the same rules that Bobby did for your safety after school. Thank you. They'll see Jimmy in school tomorrow. At home, Bobby tells his mother what a good time he had. She's pleased that Bobby can take care of himself and can be trusted to follow the rules of safety. You can follow the same rules that Bobby did for your safety after school. They'll see Jimmy in school tomorrow. At home, Bobby tells his mother what a good time he had. She's pleased that Bobby can take care of himself and can be trusted to follow the rules of safety. You can follow the same rules that Bobby did for your safety after school.